theater. Yeah, good evening.
Good evening.
Hello, welcome to the Afternoon Theater. We're so happy to have you with us for this production of the Addams Family. If you are repeating, we encourage you to keep laughing with us through this funny show. If this is your first time, you're in for a real treat. This is such a funny show. Before we get started, I want to take this moment to thank all the generous donors and sponsors who helped see the theater through the COVID-19 closure. We were closed for almost an entire year, nearly. And during that time, we didn't have any incoming money, so we had people who stepped up and helped us. And I want to take this time to give them a round of applause. We also have some housekeeping items that we need to go over before we start tonight's production, so I'm going to wait on my assistant.
Hello.
There will be a 15-minute intermission between Act 1 and Act 2, where you can visit the concession stand, use the little boys and girls rooms, or step outside for some air. The concession stand has popcorn, water, candy, all kinds of goodies, soda, all that kind of good stuff. Also, at intermission, if you need to use the restroom, the men's restroom is up this aisle through the exit sign, and it's right back there. Then we have one that is primarily used by the women, but it's all gender family bathroom up this aisle, this way. And then there is just an exclusive women's bathroom up in the balcony. If intermission, if the lines are really long, we'll push some of our cast members out of their dressing rooms, and we'll open up that space to you as well. Please take this opportunity to silence your cell phones, any device that might make any kind of notification or a beep during a show. We do not use amplification. Everything you hear is our natural voices. So we don't want to disturb the experience for any audience member or the people on the stage if we're in a very small, intimate setting. Also, there is a parental warning on this show simply for mild language and some suggestive humor. But if you do have your child with you, the theater loves having children. We just respectfully ask that if your child becomes fussy or starts making a disturbance, that you remove them from the auditorium until they calm down. Also, our agreement with the Theatrical Rights Worldwide states that we cannot have any flash photography or any video recording at all. You are allowed to take photographs, just don't have your flash on so that it doesn't disturb us up on the stage. And finally, the show does contain fog, flashing lights, and loud noises, and people do travel up and down the aisle space. So please, if you have your leg out or let your child out, beware. Without any further ado, I'll quit. Oh, there are emergency exits. I almost forgot. I cannot forget the emergency exits. My flight attendant here behind me. Our emergency exits are out the way you came, or you can come up here on stage, and there's doors to your left and the right, and they take you right out to the alley. Is that everything?
Yes.
All right. Enjoy the Addams Family.
I want to find
song. Keep playing it.
Are you all excited to be here? I think I can handle
it. I know him.
Thank you.
when you're
an ounce. That's right, when you're an ounce. Take nights out with the Addams. In one night, you're obligated to the crowd. It's family first and family last, and family by and by. When you're an Addams, the standard answers don't apply. When you're an Addams, you do what Addams do or die.
My beloved ancestors, back to your cribs.
The gate is locked.
What?
That's right. We have a problem.
His name is Lucas. Lucas Byington. And I love him.
Oh, that's right. Little Wednesday Addams. That charming, irrepressible bundle of malice who would poison her own brother just for a ride in the ambulance has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little white cottage with a picket fence and an apple tree.
I like the part about being locked up.
So, who is this Lucas fella? Is he worthy of her? Do they really love each other? What is love, anyway? Does this rash look serious to you? So many questions about love. But, when you think about it, is there really anything more important?
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh. It's okay. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Aw. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else but... Aw.
Really special. And this time you might actually
would say?
Lucas loves me and he wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beinecke loves me and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes, I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never met his parents and he's never met you guys. I just need to be sure.
That he's the one.
That the families can get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What are you saying?
I'm saying we are, and they're from Ohio.
Oh! Ohio! A swing state!
That's what I mean.
You're right, this is important. Let's go tell your mom.
No.
No, but we have to tell your mother.
Daddy, please, she'll ask a bunch of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want me to tell your mother you're getting married?
After dinner, when we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept anything from your mother.
Daddy, please.
But!
Do you love me?
But!
Do you love me, Daddy?
Ding! There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife, say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do? Boop! Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
Daddy, just one tiny little secret, please, please.
Okay, one little secret.
Oh, thank you, Daddy.
Bring it in.
Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else to make her father wonder why, oh why? Wednesday's growing up.
She'll be Thursday before you know it.
Puzzling thing, a secret in the house, a boy, a girl, a ring.
Ay-ay-ay.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen, smiling, like this. Maybe it is this boy.
This boy? Don't be silly, a high saying double hop. Ha-ha! You yourself say the puppy love. Come, darling, I feel an urge to take you in my arms. Let's go upstairs!
Oh, go, man.
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman like you are. Like you are! She could even fall in love and get married like you be.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Of course, I did not think of that.
Besides, Wednesday will have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have no reason to say this, but what if she did it? Someone stole her heart?
Don't be silly, darling. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you.
Ding! There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
die, but I fear the dice I've rolled finally cracked. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cage? How trot, trot, trot. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She stalks the Addams fire, she harbors each desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected in to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero instead of Sylvia? If the rule is true, tell me what I must do. Should I cry? Should I groan? Would I rather pass a stone? Trapped. Like a wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong, and we'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to fail, show my coffin through the nail. If I nap, if I snap, maybe dinner would be strapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Trapped.
Hey!
Back to the ship!
Thank you. Thank you.
godforsaken park.
Oh, Central Park, dear. Designed in 1857.
Wait, what? I know where we are. I was lost in the park, and a pigeon dropped at my feet with an arrow in it. And I looked up, and there she was, Wednesday, with a crossbow.
With a what?
A crossbow, you know.
This girl walks around with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
She has a permit? Good choice, son. Here's what's happening. We're going back to the hotel, and then you and I are going to have a long conversation.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
You see what you've done? Your mother's whining again. Now, here's what's happening. We're heading back, and then...
No! Normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word, one normal scene, the routine tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food. Oh, one normal night, I know it's big, but can't you see? This one normal night is for me.
Oh, he seems like such a nice young man.
No.
But they're not right for each other.
Not right for each other? What do you mean, not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the salt vaccine? Was COVID right for the quarantine? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trick. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain. But this is their moment and this is your chance. So if you don't want to remain, start singing of love.
What?
Love.
No.
Love.
Why?
Love. Only affairs of the heart. Look, the choice is yours. You either help these kids or you're stuck here for eternity.
We'll help them love.
Yes.
Love.
Yes.
Love.
Right.
Love.
Good. Love lets your spirits depart. So, let the normalcy start.
Protect and rally the let's make them the best.
One normal night is worth their gain.
Furniture.
Ah! Oh!
It's
son Lucas. And you are? Nice to meet you. Alice, nice to meet you. So we've landed in Weird City. Say drinks and then we're out of here. Surprise bag so full I can hardly lift it. The guy who patted me down at the airport slipped his phone number in my pocket. I can't take any more surprises.
Come on, Dad. Lighten up. These are your kind of people. Real salt of the earth.
Really? Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715. The Spanish warship Pico de Gallo. Commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Captain General Redondo Ventana Laguna de Jose Cuero. Leaves Madrid, bound for the New World. 3 weeks later, he is still in Madrid. His Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A sour man, he set sail anyway. Only to sink 6 months later off the southern coast of Florida. A hostile land infested with mosquitoes, rattlesnakes, and many retired Jewish peoples. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Bikini, I presume?
It's fine.
And the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Bikini.
Oh, hi,
And you must be young Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son with a massive thyroid problem.
I go too far.
No matter, the night she is young, welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez, Florencia Adams, at your service. Allow me to present my wife, La Duena, mother of my children, El Amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia!
I'm sorry I'm late. I was putting an apple pie in the windowsill to cool.
That's my little woman, a duchess in the parlor, and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, go.
And a gymnast in the bedroom.
Very pleased to meet you, Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Adams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
Alice. And you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I'm named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own legs.
Son, they don't need to know that story.
No, it's a beautiful story. Wednesday had a cousin once who swallowed his tongue. He ha 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 ha.
Thank you, Mother. Hi, I'm Wednesday. What are you wearing? A dress? A yellow dress.
Mama, what happened? You look like a minion.
Family. Hi! I just got back from the hospital.
don't do any of those things.
Well, honey, you're a nun.
Are you ready for some football? Fester's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that sumbitch go. He's on the corner. He's grabbing third. And touchdown. And the crowd goes wild.
This is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you, Fester. All right. Go away now.
So long, farewell, I'll be here, say goodbye.
And now for a welcoming toast from the extensive Addams Kids.
Children, you may be excused.
Come on, Lucas. Daddy, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma.
Hey, keep the door open, you hear?
Ah, you're concerned they will make the beast, eh? Don't worry, my friend. My daughter has a black belt in Thai Kwando. If he tries anything, she'll rip his throat out.
Poor children.
Excuse me. Do you have a little girl's room?
We used to, but we let them all go.
Morticia, a grand tour for the missus, and then Mr. and I will go below for some guy stuff. Then dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
The game? What kind of game?
Did you ever play charades?
Oh, sure.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Thank you. anything queasy there in Madrid.
What that sort of thing?
A man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me, I collect instruments of persuasion. Why, you ask? Go on, ask!
Why?
It's fun. The history of the world told in agony and dismemberment. Get up, I show you. You sit down, they ask you a question, they don't like the answer, and... Ooh! That'll make you believe, hey! Go on, sit down, let me ask you a question.
Maybe another time.
Okie dokie. So, how about these crazy kids, eh?
Well, what about them?
They seem very fond of each other, no?
I guess, not like they're getting married or anything.
Married? Of course not, they're so young! Of course they do marry young these days, do they not?
I don't know what they do.
Then speak of you, the Bikini Saga! Your lives, your hopes, your dreams, your son.
Lucas? He's a good kid, a little soft, takes after his mom, but once he graduates college, I'm gonna take him under my wing, show him the family business, you know, make a man of him.
May I say something? You and I feel we understand each other.
Do you feel this?
No. Addams, you know what, 10,000 square feet, middle of Central Park? How'd you swing that?
These 2 acres have been in my family ever since Queen Isabella of Spain deeded them to my great ancestor, Alfonso the Enormous, for services rendered.
Services?
Alfonso the Enormous. The Enormous! Do I have to throw you a diagram?
No.
Come, Bikini, I show you the moat. Did you bring your band, sir?
Never mind, let's be crazy.
Looking over her shoulder.
the summer, I work at Raimi. It's a grocery store.
Is any of this true?
Most of it.
And in your time off, Raimi boy?
Well, mostly I think about Wednesday and how much I love her, and how we could have a wonderful life together.
What does a Lucas McKinney become when it grows up?
Maybe a writer, or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner? Why?
Because you get to look at the inside of people's bodies, and they don't mind because they're dead.
If I'm keeping anything from you now.
That it should come to this.
Here, Kara, I feel an urge to take you in my arms.
No, Gomez.
What?
Not today.
But you've never turned down a trip to heaven.
Not today. And when you're ready to share like a proper husband, you'll find me in my room.
If she never tortures me anymore, how would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? Why would she be so cruel? could stab my arm myself, could rip my tonsils out, could set my hair aflame. I could spray my eyes with mace, but face the fact without her, it wouldn't be the same.
Thank you.
weeks, all thanks to my fabulous lady wife, from whom I keep nothing. This dinner puts me in mind of my great ancestor, Hector Fernando Escondido a Chimichanga. A man hated by the church, but clever with a quip. In fact, while being burned alive, he told the priest, keep it pink in the middle, a little crispy on the outside.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please, not the game. It's getting really late.
But it's a family tradition.
Huxley, could you just go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will.
Tara, maybe the game's a bad idea.
Thank you, Daddy.
No, the game is a good idea. And if it isn't, then someone will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
Actually, the game is a good idea. The best of all ideas. We call it Obligacion de Revelar.
Oh, Spanish! What does it mean? Full disclosure.
Exactly. Everyone sips from the sacred family chalice.
And discloses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And they have to absolutely tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there will be consequences.
Oh, I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
I'm not sure you would.
Oh, no.
And now my husband will break the ice. Gomez has something he needs to disclose.
No. The horse goes last.
Lurch, the sacred chalice.
This is a sacred chalice. From Addams family's past, burning my digitalis, hail fast, podcast! Here in this sweet libation, salvation resides. Heal a sweet sensation, revelation provides. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people.
Full disclosure,
it's a hell of a thing. I want some favor on the late day jumping. How does it matter if you're right or left wing? Feel like this full disclosure.
Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure.
And in this dream, I was a gold. And then I had to... No. I can't! No, really, I can't! Okay, so I'm a gold. Leaping crag to crag like we do.
Me! Me!
There before me appears a beautiful lady gold, her haunches trembling in the mist.
Me! Me!
Just as I'm about to embrace her, a crow appears, saying, I will open her face.
Wah, 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 wah.
And this crow, silly bird, what do you know through love? Then suddenly, my beautiful lady goat is transformed into a drum roll. Transformed into a club. The most luscious of all fruits. I take a bite and the juice. The juice is sweet. Full disclosure.
So now I'm a goat.
No!
I'm a goat with a beard and horns.
So we lose the goat. No goats. I hate goats. Just a plum, yes.
Well, we'll just have to come back to you. Wednesday's turn. Pass.
Oh, me.
Yes, let's hear from Baxter. The chalice.
Thank you. I am in love.
Oh.
You're probably thinking, what could a fat, bald person with no specific sexuality know about love? But I, too, am in love. Fester loves.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon.
The moon.
That's normal.
full disclosure.
Full disclosure.
Just embracing its moon.
Embracing its moon.
Fall from grace or fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon.
Close your sermon with a signature tune.
And call it full disclosure.
My wife's not feeling well. We'll be going now.
No! We're in the middle of a game!
dark, even for us.
Full disclosure.
Well, the story was grim.
We're talking grim.
Filled with fear and loathing up to the brim.
That's quite a grim.
Just imagine being married to him.
Hey, Addams. I tried. I really did. I thought the kids like each other. Why not? But you people are all insane. You got a house where there shouldn't be a house. You got a zombie for a butler, and there's a man dating the moon?
I wouldn't say we're dating.
We're simple people, Mr. Addams. We're not used to your fancy New York way of life. So with your permission, we're going back to the real America. Full disclosure. Lucas, help me get your mother off the table.
You were right, Lucas.
Right about what?
Thanks anyway, Daddy.
Thanks for what?
It doesn't matter. Lucas and I love each other. We're getting married.
What?
Married!
That's what you kept for me?
Married!
No secrets, huh?
Yes, we kept a secret.
Getting married. Married, married. Are they getting married? Really married, married, married. Full disclosure, what a miserable game. Play it once and life is never the same. Someone started it, so someone's to blame. Enough of
Shame.
sweet, my own. Whitsell wasn't sure about the boy and didn't want to worry you.
Oh, so you didn't dare tell me because I'm such a terrible mother.
You are a wonderful mother.
And look at the thanks I get. I gave up my dreams for the sake of this family. I wanted to travel. I wanted to see Paris. I've never seen the sewers of Paris. And now it'll never happen.
But the car!
So this is how it ends. Alone and forgotten in a tiny room. Surviving on cat food and broken dreams. That's what happens to mothers. Look at yours. She came for the weekend. Weeks turned into months. It's 12 years later and she's still up there. Deceived. Deluded. Smoking weed in the attic. Well, I'm not going to end up like your mother.
My mother? I thought she was your mother. Oh, seriously.
You lied to me. I can't live
with that. Oh, here, Carl. I feel an urge to take you in my arms.
Not today.
Well, Carl!
Out.
You have-
death. All is black inside my face.
And they really got to you. That didn't even rhyme.
You got a problem with that?
Listen, I don't know about you, but I didn't raise our son to be kidnapped by a bunch of creeped out left-wing Spanish weirdos.
You didn't raise him, Mal. I did. You were at the office, remember?
I was at the office for you and for him. I had plans for the boy.
Oh, Mal, he's in love. Let him follow his heart.
Follow his heart?
Hey,
that's
Sean.
Crazy.
Can I talk to Sean?
What's wrong with crazy? Crazy is underrated.
So let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, plans to run off and marry a girl named for a day of the week, who in her spare time wanders Central Park at night with a crossbow, and you're just fine with all of that.
If he's in love, yes!
Well, you better come to your senses or I'm gonna have to start taking steps.
Oh, good idea! Why don't you start by taking steps outside?
What?
You wanna act like a tool? Go sleep in the shed!
Each meeting, a happy reunion.
When the daylight ends, then the moon ascends, I would rather be just the moon. When I feel her pull, then my heart is full, and the night is softly, sweetly calling, Fester, look and see, la 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 la, la 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 la, la 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 la. It's a dream that's coming true. When the moon says, I love you. So pretty. Though I'm told it's wrong, when I sing my song, she accepts, she attends, she believes, she befriends. Thank you.
elopement?
Daddy, would you just please let
me? No, no, no. This is what comes from keeping secrets. If the two of you wanted to get married, you should have.
There's not gonna be any marriage.
No? Why?
Failed.
What? A breach of promise? An outrage!
He thought running away was a bad idea.
On the other hand, he does have a point.
I hate him.
He's a beginning, something to build on.
He says he can't live without me, and then he just lets me leave. I love him. Why doesn't he love me back?
You just said you hated him. Which is it?
Both.
Ah, now you've got it.
Tiny bit sad.
standing there in the shadows?
My whole life?
Nice! You should be a writer. You met my daughter. This is Winston. The best thing that will ever happen to you. Don't screw it up.
Yes?
Look, I can't stand the idea of not being with you.
5 minutes ago you could.
But see, the lover always comes back. Ulysses, Tristan, Romeo.
Listen, I'm homeschooled. What's your point?
I'd rather die than live without you.
Okay. Prove it.
What?
Prove it.
Where's
the apple on your head and go stand against the tree.
What? No, you're crazy.
Without me, and you're not crazy enough. That's the problem.
T-shirt?
And headband.
You know, you were really crazy back then, you know that?
I know. I guess I got stuck, Alice, more than most men. But Mama, I swear I'll be crazy again.
Mal, you're rhyming!
Just for you, honey. Just for you.
Coffin. Better.
secret, then she throws me out.
What could I do? I was trapped.
But my darling, my only one, I make it up to you. You want to see the world? Done. You want to see the sewers? I'll show you sewers fit for a queen. Where's the hotel guy?
Ah, Hotel Merde, through the toilet. Condemned 6 times by the Board of Health. You're right, not enough. Ah, voila! Hotel Nosferatu. Rating -3 stars, no windows, no towels, no staff. Bingo! The worst hotel in Paris. Get them on the line! Hurry, my friend! This is the final round!
Did I ever once believe this day would come? Did I ever once expect the worst? Did I ever dream that I could feel this way? Dios mio, no, this is the first. I'm a Latin man and Latin men are smart. Everything we do is muy sincere. Leading with a sword as much as with a heart. Never once was I prepared to hear. Not today, she spat it in my face. Not today, not even second base. Not today, the words I heard her say. Not today, not today, not today. I remember well the day she poisoned me. No one else had cared enough to try. How did she uncover all the joys in me? Always she promised I would die. Every year that passes I adore her more. Anyone who knows us would agree. She's my every fever, flu, and canker sore. She's my only hepatitis B. Not today, I'm dancing on my own. Not today, I'm done without the bone. Not today, that running from the lane. Not today, not today, not today.
Set my goal to Paris, it's about time. Hello, Hotel Nosferatu? The future of my marriage is at stake.
Can you confirm this is the worst hotel in Paris? Because I need to get your ghoulish guarantee. What would you pay if I could say you serve my petit déjeuner from an abandoned and condemned patisserie? I must be clear, don't want to circulate misnomers. You must have roaches in the bath at any cost. It says right here in my new guide I bought from Frommer's that even in July the pipes are thick with frost.
Gomez! Gomez! Morticia's leaving!
What?
She's at the gate with the police! It's the end of the family!
This is the moment where I turn a little gray. This is the moment where my marriage vows decay. This is the moment where Morticia runs away. No! Not today! Not today! Not today!
Let's tell your mother. And what did you say?
How
possibly remember what
you said? No! She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
Well, that's different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, and withholding, and loved nothing more than stirring up trouble.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God. I've turned into my mother.
And Wednesday is you. Isn't it wonderful?
You did that like a lawyer.
No, just a husband and a father. Not so easy. In fact, very difficult.
Let's live before we die. Let's laugh before we cry. Let's hold each other tight. And that's if I have caused you pain, it's easy to explain. Come fill me with the light. And that's my love, my wife, forever you will be. But Wednesday's life, that too is part of me. To women I adore, and swore to suffer for. Let's end this tug of war. And that's
my mother told me to beware of clever men with silver tongues.
What I lack in depth, I make up for in shallowness.
You think you can sway me with a joke?
It's the last thing I try before the chloroform.
Get this part right.
Stay right where you are and dance.
I'm not a castanet who clicks with no regret.
You're more than that by far, so dance. The place we're in can never be what was. And we began the duel of dancing dance. My darling, I was bad. Bad husband and bad dad, instead of being sad.
Alone,
we're lost, we're drifting out to sea.
But
side by side, we're gloomy as can be, as gloomy as can be. Morticia, I was wrong, I knew it all along. Forgive me. The song
thank you.
changed our lives.
How can we ever thank you?
Tell your friends. Word of mouth is so important. Young lady, step forward and speak the words that every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry. Do you really want to marry this boy?
I do.
Why?
He's willing to die for me.
Mother, can I ask you something? Yes.
Go ahead, ask her.
Can we have your blessing?
Of course. And may you have many children who bring you as much grief as you've given us.
Attention, everybody! I have a full disclosure! I'm taking my beautiful, sexy wife to Paris!
Oh, Gomez, the sewers.
Special package, 7 days, 1 night.
Je t'aime, mon cher. Je t'aime toujours.
Oh, the French!
Your sister.
So you stole my acrimonium.
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with one another.
But I never got to drink it because...
I passed it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And then I reached deep into my reservoir of womanly compassion and bathed your father in forgiveness.
Welcome to our family. We are closing a daughter. We're gaining 3 Beinekes. My son, for purely selfish motives, you turn a simple dinner party into a night from hell.
We couldn't be more proud.
Huxley, you're an artist. You rearranged life itself and it all came out even. You're the best little brother anyone can ever ask for.
So you'll still torture me?
Of course. Until you get a girl of your own.
My son, you embrace the darkness of your despair, and suddenly the world makes sense. You are a true Addams.
And the light we see fades away in.
Oh, I'm coming, my love! Stay full alive!
Fly, my wounded brother! Fly on wings of love!
Thank you. Just a moment. I have to restart the program for some reason. It's being stupid. If I could get a techie person in the crew to come down and help me, that'd be awesome.
When you're in a bind, hire Fester's tech support.
I'm getting the circle, the rainbow. Hmm. The magic of live theater.
We'll have business cards in the lobby.